Hello, I'm going to give you here a description about India, you know, what happened before the arrival of the second anointed Christ, Nanak, Satguru Nanak Dev Ji. Before that, we used to have what we called it, Bhagat. Now, they were in India, we have this Bhakti Marg. Bhakti Marg mean a, way. Bhakti means submission to the will of God. That means you love everyone and you do not hurt anyone. If somebody hit you, you present the other cheek, as Christ Jesus has told, instructed people. So they used to preach gospel also. So they used to sing the praises of our Father and they used to quote their own name at the end. Kabir says so, Bhakt Namdev says so. So they were quoting their name. So they were, in fact, they were Satgurus, not Bhagat, because they were preaching gospel. So whereas Satguru Nanak Dev Ji was anointed Christ or anointed Satguru, as Christ Jesus was the first one, Nanak was the second anointed Christ, or the second coming of Jesus was Nanak. Now this fact is hardly known to any, and you will not know, because the last Christ on earth, Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji, stressed that the word of God or the gospel would be known to one in a million. People will not be loving Mammon, they will be loving Mammon and not loving God at all. So today, if you go to India or any place, over there, even these holy men, they are looking forward to some Mammon money. There are quite a few holy men who are not bothered about Mammon. They are devoted to God, but they are very few to be come across. And then to have this knowledge gospel is another problem, because most of them, they are bogged down in what the other people say and they don't ponder over the things that what comes out of your mouth should make sense. So what they normally say as prevalent in India, say Nanak, these antichrist Cathers, they have addressed Nanak as a guru. Guru means a Brahman guru, rabbi. Now, he was not a moral teacher, he was a spiritual preacher. And the spokesmen of God are known as a Satguru. Satguru imparts education to your mind, whereas a guru imparts education to your physical body, which is washable with water. So that's why in the guru, Brahman guru, water is important as a cleaning agent, whilst in Satguru, his word is important for cleansing our hearts. So that's why I say, cleanse your heart so that Christ Jesus can enter into your heart and make you to preach gospel, give you confidence to preach gospel. So in India we have many Satgurus, Satguru Kabir Ji and other, which they were known as Bhagat. But as I said, you know, Bhagat could be anyone who is meek and loving and who understand the things. or a perfect Sikh is a Bhagat as well as he preaches a gospel. He is a Christ, you know, Gurmukh. So Christ with small c, not with capital C. So after the arrival of Satguru Nanak Dev Ji, then I hardly find any Bhagat, you know, in India who was preaching gospel in his own name. So after the arrival of Satguru Nanak Dev Ji, all the people who are learned the gospel from the house of Christ Nanak, they preach gospel to honor Christ Nanak, to glorify our Father God. So for you to preach gospel or to understand gospel, you need to be a sensible person of spirit, which are there in India, but the Mammon kills them, or what the other people will say about if I preach this thing, what the other people will react. They are frightened of the fanatics. So if you want to preach gospel, you need to be solitary and you need to make use of your inner man. Inner man is Christ sitting in your heart. Make use of him, wake him up, and then only he will guide you to gospel through logical reasoning. Logical reasoning is the tool that you dig the field in which the treasures are buried. Gospel treasures are not on the surface, they are buried. So you have to dig them. So what I say, you know, that after the appearance of Christ Nanak in India, all those holy men who have devoted their lives, they all sing the praises of God through what Christ Nanak has preached. Now in India, this preaching of Satguru Nanak Dev Ji was perfect and very methodical. We had six Christ after in the line of Christ Nanak, and we had four royal kings. Today, most of these so-called Sikhs, they don't know the difference between Guru Nanak and Satguru Nanak. So if they don't know the difference, then they do not know the importance of the four royal king. We call them Sache Pasha. Sache Pasha say, the royal king are above everyone. So they are higher than the Christ Nanak. So they even call them Guru Gobind Singh. Now he was not a guru, he was a royal king. So it's very degrading to address a royal king, a guru. Guru means Brahman guru, which is the moral teacher. So this is the standard of knowledge in India. So if anybody in India, you know, who addresses Nanak as Satguru, he has some knowledge. And some of these hypocrites, they themselves, like this Satguru Ram Singh of the Kuka branch, he himself calls himself as a Satguru and addresses Nanak as a guru. What a blindness.